Good morning to everybody. I welcome you all to this session, and today we are going to discuss about processing and post-harvest aspects of fisheries. As you know, fisheries is a very vital sector in the country and is assumes a lot of importance in the human nutrition, because the India is facing a lot of challenges regarding the nutritional security and the food security. In this view, fisheries assumes a lot of importance. As you know, fish is highly nutritious, rich in proteins, fats, minerals, vitamins, and also other growth promoting factors. At the same time, fish is also highly perishable. It spoils very fast. As soon as it is caught, it needs to be preserved. So what happens is, immediately after catch, we have to reduce the temperature. By reducing the temperature, the fish can be stored and preserved for longer duration. So the best and easiest way of preserving the temperature and keeping it for longer time is by icing. As you know, ice is the cheapest method of preservation, and it is very easy and convenient to do the icing. So as soon as fish is harvested, what we have to do is, we have to immediately ice it, and preferably it should be done in a layer wise. So the ice should be on the top and ice also should be at the bottom, so that ice will come in contact with the fish and reduce the temperature. So as the temperature reduces, fish can be automatically preserved for longer time. And icing, you know, you have different types of ice. You have block ice, we have tube ice, we have flake ice. And the best is the flake ice, because flake ice comes in contact with the fish uniformly. So thereby the temperature can be reduced effectively. And also when ice is melting, it will also wash away all the dirt, bacteria and other contaminants. Then once ice is done, and it can be kept for a shorter duration. But what happens is, icing is not the ultimate, because icing is only a short term preservation. In case you want to keep it for longer period, you have to go for other preservation techniques. And also in icing, there are some advanced technologies like chilled seawater preservation and also refrigerated seawater. In case of the vessels which are going for longer duration of fishing, where you need to catch it on board and store it, you can have a fishing tank wherein you preserve the fish in a refrigerated seawater condition. Wherein what we are doing is, we are taking the seawater or the potable water into the fish tank, and we are cooling it by using a refrigeration system. So thereby what happens, we can cool large quantity of fish. But again, as I told you, fish is having a limited shelf life in icing. So the next best alternative is by freezing. So what happens in freezing? We are converting the water in the fish to ice. So what we are doing, by using refrigeration mechanical system, we reduce the temperature from the normal ambient temperature of around 28 to 30 degrees to maybe around sub-zero. So what happens when the fish water is frozen below zero, the freezing point, the bacterial and enzymatic action will be reduced. So by this, fish can be kept for longer time. So freezing, again, what happens is, we have to do quick freezing. If the freezing is taking place at a lower speed, what happens? The ice crystal formation will be, the ice crystal will be very big. They will damage the fish muzzle. That will affect the quality of the fish, frozen fish. So what we have to do is, we have to do quick freezing. And icing, again freezing, we have different techniques like air blast freezing, we have contact plate freezing, and we have immersion freezing. And you know, if we have a size, you know, a rectangular shape of a definite shape, we can do it in a contact plate freezing. If you have a irregular shape of fish, we can do with the air blast freezing, or we can do immersion freezing in liquid nitrogen or brine freezing. And again, frozen storage, we have to make sure that after freezing, they are kept in a storage without much of fluctuation in temperature. If there is a fluctuation in temperature, what happens? Automatically the quality of the frozen fish is lost. Of course, frozen fish is almost equal to fresh fish when it is thawed. Okay? So we have to ensure that good quality raw material is used. We use the quick freezing technique, and also ensure that there is no change fluctuation of temperature in the frozen storage. Then another important fish preservation technique traditionally we have been using is curing techniques. In curing, what we are doing, either we are drying the fish or we are salting the fish. So drying is normally done under sun, because you know India is a tropical country, and we have a lot of sunshine. So what happens, sunshine, when we are exposing the fish outside, it will remove the moisture, and once the moisture is removed, automatically fish gets preserved. But the problem is, traditionally we are doing on beach. What happens when we do the sun drying on the beach? It gets a lot of contamination from sand, dust, you know, a lot of stray animals are coming. So you know, in India the conditions are very different compared to Western countries. So the problem is maintaining the quality in the sun-dried fish is difficult. So what we have done, we have developed artificial dryers by using solar drying or mechanical electrical dryers. That also will help in reducing the moisture. Then another way of technique is the salt curing, because traditionally, you know, you have been, I think many of you must have seen, the salt cured fish is a very delicacy, because in monsoon time when fishing is banned, you have to depend on fish, because people are getting aware about the quality of fish, importance of fish in the human diet. So what happens is, you need to go for a traditional technique like salting and curing. So salting, again we can have different technique like dry salting, mono curing, Colombo curing, wet salting. What we do, we simply add, rub the salt onto the fish and we allow it to settle there. What happens, the fish, salt when it is going into the fish, the moisture comes out and a self brine is formed and it is preserved in the fish. I mean, the whole self brine is preserving the fish. Then after that, either you dry it again or it is marketed as such. Then another technique of fish preservation is by canning. So canning means you are thermally processing the fish, you are not adding any preservatives, and it can be kept for more than 2 years at ambient temperature. That is the advantages of canning. So canning, we use different containers like tin cans, aluminium cans, tin freestick cans. But another advantage in that is the cost of the preservation is without any preservatives, and only by applying heat we are preserving the product, and it can be kept for longer time. So it is a convenient product. See, nowadays people are interested in convenient products, because ladies are working, we don't have time for bringing fish and making it to the table. So what we do, this sort of convenient products, ready to eat, ready to cook, these things are always very important. So what we are doing, the another development in the canning is retort pouch processing. In case of retort pouch processing, what we are doing, instead of a rigid container, we are using a flexible container, where we are using polyester, aluminium foil and polypropylene as a plastic material, wherein the fish is packed inside, thermally processed and kept at ambient temperature for preservation. It is very good, actually it serves a similar purpose of canning. So after canning, the freezing, you know, another technique is, see, the many of the small fishes we are not using directly for consumption. They are all thrown or made into manure or fish meal. You know, the nutritional, you know, the highly protein rich fish is thrown into the, it is not used for human consumption. What we are doing is, a new technique called minced meat technology is developed, you know, value addition, because nowadays people are interested in convenient products. So diversification and value addition are playing vital role in the economy of our country by improving the fisheries, in the fisheries sector. So what's happening is, you do take the small varieties of fishes, you take out the meat, you freeze it and keep it, wherein we can develop many value added products like fish fingers, fish wafers, fish cutlets. All these are having ready market. Instead of bringing the whole fish, if you have products like this, they have very acceptance, you know, in especially the supermarket culture is coming to India. Lot of retail kiosks are coming, people are going to the supermarket just buying whatever they want. So we have lot of convenience products in the market. So the minced meat technology, and also surumi, you know, you heard of surumi. Surumi is a Japanese term actually. So it is basically comminuted fish farm. So it is called fish keema, we also call it as fish keema. So the small varieties, you know, which are not having ready commercial value, what you do, you bring it to the processing factory, you remove, you know, putting a deboner, you take out the meat, you take it out, then you preserve, you know, normally in surumi what we do, we wash it with chilled water. When we wash it with chilled water, what happens is, all the fat, you know, blood, you know, all unwanted things are all washed away. Then what happens, the fish meat is actually frozen and stored. And that can be used for making many surumi based products like kamaboko, chikuwa, sausages, you know, all these have tremendous potential in the domestic as well as export market. Then when you are talking of value addition, see, the fish is a highly nutritious product. When it is harvested, post harvest loss is a major concern in our country, because fish is, you know, as we are telling, it is, you know, having a lot of export market, and we are earning foreign exchange to the tune of so many crores, and it is a very important sector in the Indian economy. What happens, 60% is only edible, that is being used for production of products and this thing, whereas the 40% which is waste, you know, in the form of head, scales, bones, all these things are actually highly productive, you know, we can make high value products from them. But the problem is, right now we don't have a mechanism to use them. So the waste, what we are calling as byproducts. Byproducts means, from the waste develop high value products. So you know, many products are there. For example, the prawn, you see, the shrimp. Shrimp has got very good demand. I think, I am sure all of you will like shrimp, the prawn or shrimp, whatever you say. So the prawn, once the shell is removed, the shell is waste. Whereas it is not so. The shell is highly productive, you know. From the shell we can make products like chitin and chitosan, which has got lot of medicinal, pharmaceutical and industrial uses. Okay. So this chitin and chitosan can be used for many applications. At the same time, you take the head or skin or the bones, we can make fish calcium. You know, the fish oil, you know, you heard of fish meal. See, fish meal is a major ingredient for feed for animal poultry. You know, the poultry industry is growing very well. The animal industry, the pig industry, all these things are growing very well because there is a lot of demand for these products in the market. So what we are doing, we are using this fish meal, that is the small, you know, intestine, all the fish waste. What we are doing, we are cooking it, we are pressing it, taking out the oil. If it is oily fish, if it is a non-oily fish, we do the dry reduction purpose, and this fish meal is going directly for rising as a fish meat incorporated. Or else you take out the oil, oil is separated, you know, fish oil is used for industrial purpose, and also oil from shark liver, you know, it is highly having medicinal property. It has contains compounds like squalene. Squalene is used in treating cancer. It is used as anti-aging compounds. You know, all the ladies are using face creams. Face creams has this squalene because it gives you, you know, it will reduce your wrinkles. So there is tremendous potential. You take the fish scales, we can make pearl essence. Or from fish scales, we are making things called hydroxyapatite. It can be used as a bone supplement. Okay. And fish leather, you know, the skin is normally thrown in the market. If you collect this leather, if the skin, it can be converted into leather and many beautiful, you know, bags, your footwear, all these can be made from the leather. And apart from this, many other components, you know, it is like your fish is like your coconut, you know, kalpavruksham, or it is like a elephant. You know, you have uses from the top to bottom. You take the head, you know, from, I told you again, skin you can use, bone you can use, then you can use the oil, you can use the fish meal, which is the bone and all the offal, you know, even intestine. You know, we have developed technologies from the intestine to make sutures. You know, from the sutures, it can be self-absorbable. You know, instead of using synthetic sutures, we can use sutures from this. Then apart from, another thing is fish gelatin. You know, normally we are using gelatin from the bovine source. Bovine source, you know, many of the people are vegetarians. If I say it is from bovine source, people will not use. Whereas gelatin from fish, it can be used for, you know, confectionery industry, your bakery industry. So there are plenty of uses from fish. And you take off a shark, you know, your fins, normally they were exported. You know what happens? In the fin you have rays. These rays are as delicacy in Japan and other Southeast Asian countries for making into soup. So we have tremendous uses. So the fisheries industry is growing. We have to, you know, make it profitable. So in order to do this, first of all we have to do value addition, diversification, and make convenient products from the fish and shellfish, and also make it suitable for the domestic market and also to the export market. Then apart from that, the waste, you know, we should not call them as waste. They are all the byproducts. You make many byproducts from that, and from that what we are doing, we are making high value products. So in order to make the fisheries industry profitable, we have to apply the technologies available. You know, fish is preserved, already I told you in the beginning itself, fish is highly perishable. So in order to make it, keep it for longer period, you know, you have to make it available to the consumers, you have to make it available to the human and as well as animal feed and other sectors. What we have to do, we have to intervene with the technologies, make it, you know, apply all the technologies for preservation, make it available for longer period, and also ensure that the fish is, the nutritional supplement is given to the public. You know, India is growing, population is exploding. So we need the nutritional security for our country. So for this, the best is to use the aquatic resources. It is not only fish, shellfish, seaweeds are very important. So, and also India is giving lot of importance for culture of fishes. Now it is growing, unlike agriculture, fisheries is getting lot of importance. So we have to diversify, we have to make products, and we have to use the waste and make byproducts. Then only the fisheries industry will survive. And you know, now the industries, if you really see, the contribution of Indian fisheries to the GDP is increasing. So fisheries is a very important sector. So we all are responsible for this, because, you know, unlike the agriculture products, fish will spoil very fast. That is a major thing. So we have to intervene, we have to be responsible, you know, sanitation hygiene, we have to train people, you know, the fishermen who are catching, from there it has to be intervened, because they are not aware, they are illiterates. They are simply taking the fish and putting on the desk, you know, the deck of the boat. So we have to start intervention from there. We have to see that sanitation hygiene practices are followed, fish is immediately iced, or it is brought to the factory, maybe it is converted into frozen product or dried product or semi-dried product, or another technology is smoking products. You can do smoking technology, or we can do thermal processing, we can do retort poach processing, or we can do many other technologies are coming into the market. So we have to develop value added products, and we have to see that they are suitable for the particular community, because the fish product which is accepted in Tamil Nadu may not be accepted in Delhi. So what we have to do, the technology is already available. So what we have to do, we have to ensure that these technologies are applied, and we ensure that good quality fish is supplied to the consumers. Thank you very much.